In this video, I'm going to walk you through a case study of a property that we bought using the slow flip strategy. And if you're unfamiliar with the slow flip strategy, there's a link in the notes where we talk more about that. But basically, it's like the BRRRR strategy with a little extra twist to allow you to actually exponentially grow a rental portfolio. And before we get into the video, if you get any value out of this, please click the like button, comment below, let me know what you think. And you can even join our free community at investedagents.com/community. So this house is located in a low desirable area in Rosenberg, Texas. It's actually a duplex, and the seller built it himself, so he was very proud of it. But because it was in a flood zone, according to the seller, the house didn't flood, but the property did, like the land did, but the house didn't. But because it's a low desirable area and it's already kind of like trashy around it and it's in a flood zone, the actual like aftermarket value was, it wasn't much. And we definitely weren't going to make a lot if we tried to flip it, but because it was a duplex and we knew we'd be able to rent it very well, we decided to actually keep it as a rental using the slow flip strategy, because we knew over time values would increase and rents would increase. If nothing else, it'd be a good cash flow machine for us. But eventually the values would go up to where we could sell it if we wanted to. We'd have a good exit strategy. So that's what we did. It really didn't need a lot of work. It was a small house, so we had to do a make ready. But as you can tell, it's in fair condition, despite being in this area and having tenants in them that I think one of them wasn't even paying. So it looked like it was in fair condition. We ended up buying it and putting about $11,000 into it. We had to build a new deck and do some interior trim work, paint, and then fixtures throughout. But once we did that, we were actually able to get it rented, and it stayed rented pretty well throughout the time we owned it. Here's another picture of the inside after we did the full remodel. So this is what the numbers look like on this property. We bought it for $75,000. That's more than I wanted to pay. I was actually trying to get it between $65,000 and $70,000, and he was originally asking well over $80,000. So we settled on 75, and I was able to make that work because I knew it would cash flow. And I knew it would cash flow really well at that price, and I had the ability to get financing. So I was still comfortable with that, even though I wanted to get a little bit lower. Initially, we put in a little over $11,000 in repairs, very cosmetic work, nothing structural initially. We had ongoing maintenance, of course, throughout the when we had it as a rental, but initially a little over $11,000. So cash flow through the time we owned it, which was just right around 2 years or a little bit more than 2 years, it was $19,633. That's net cash flow to us after all, like PI, TI, and of course repairs and maintenance too. And then what we originally thought, values would eventually push up over time, and they did. So what we thought was maybe worth 110, like possibly 120 initially, which after you factor closing costs and repairs and hold time and just sunk costs, insurance and stuff like that, it would not have made sense for a flip. But because we held it, we were able to sell it eventually at $157,000. We were asking, I think, $159,000. We got $157,000 fairly quickly, giving us a gross profit of over $90,000 on this property. And because we held it long-term, it's now a long-term capital gain. So that's $90,000 that we can go and reinvest in several different rental properties, reinvest in the business. So this is just another example of the slow flip strategy, where you can take a property that maybe doesn't either make sense as a flip, so you just end up flipping it over time and making your money over a period of time versus all at once, or at least within a 3 to 6 month time period. So Think about that when you're doing your next flip, especially if it's a lower margin flip. As opposed to looking at 3 to 6 months, look at 3 to 6 years. How can you play that out over 3 to 6 years? Just figure out what the average appreciation rate is. Maybe like at the time of this recording, 2021, like appreciation is pretty crazy right now. So don't bet on that every year, but cut that in half or maybe even less than that, or go back to normal type appreciation that your market experienced between 2016 and 2020. Like, what did that look like? And then play that out over a 3, 4, 5, 10 year period and see what that can do to the value, what you would earn from a cash flow perspective over that time. And that way, whenever you actually buy it, rent it out, and then 5 years later end up getting to that point, what can you do with that cash? And how much more will you have to play with to invest in your next project, maybe an apartment complex or whatever it is that maybe it's just your lifestyle. You want to take it, but I always recommend reinvesting back in your business. So if you got any value out of this, again, please leave a comment, click the like button. Definitely want to hear back from you. You can join our community at investedagents.com/community and get a free book called the Private Lenders Playbook, which will show you actually how we work with private lenders like the ones that actually funded this deal. So thanks for watching.